has returned. Free from their imprisonment, ancient wizard kings come, seeking lost magics and new realms to conquer, turning all whom they encounter by choice or by force. Through strife, champions arise. New unities are founded. And powerful arcane knowledge unlocked. As gods and mortals clash, the forces unleashed will shape a new age of wonders.
Welcome to Magehaven. Magehaven is a sanctuary between worlds. From here, powerful rulers called Godir venture to realms within the Astral Sea. As you conquer realms, other Godir will gather in Magehaven and join your pantheon. You will also gather pantheon experience, which unlocks new options for creating your Godir and their followers. Your pantheon will tell your story of the fourth age of wonders. Step through the world gate. Your first adventure awaits. In the following steps, you will create your people, followed by your ruler. In this step, what defines their society? Choose your first tome of magic. What is your ruler's origin? Reveal yourself. Your journey begins. Look around and familiarize yourself with your new surroundings. You can take a closer look at the land by zooming in, or get a better overview of the world by zooming out. Zoom out far enough to reach the overview map. You have reached the overview map. As you explore the world, you have selected an army. An infestation is close by. Your army. You are about to begin exploring your surroundings. While the wide world holds plenty of things to find, two of the most valuable places. You can open the encyclopedia to find information about various units, mechanics, or spells. Huh? You have encountered a resource node. They provide additional yield to the province they are located in. Nodes are often occupied by marauders. To claim the node and its benefits, these guards will need to be removed first. Research enables you to learn new spells and acquire new units. You have selected one of your cities. Cities are central to your economy and allow you to build more units for your armies. Locations and province improvements located in the city's domain will provide you with income. Structures. You're about to enter combat. Cities also recruit your units. Units cost upkeep. You have gathered a large amount of Imperium. This represents the influence you have over the world. You can use it to acquire new cities, unlock new Empire skills, or speed up city growth. This is the... Stability measures how happy the people in your cities are. Outside of dark cultures, which do not suffer from low stability penalties, you generally want to keep your stability high. One of your heroes has gained a level. This grants them a skill point they can spend on a hero skill from one of their skill trees. Represents how others see you. This can be when you are inside of the domain belonging to your enemy, you can pillage their province improvements to gain resources. You have selected a hero. Heroes lead your armies around the world. Only they have the authority to explore ancient wonders, construct outposts, or... This is your spell list. You can cast various spells from here to bolster your units and cities. This is the Empire Development Tree. Here you will specialize your empire towards certain playstyles. Increase your Empire's affinity to open more options. You have encountered another ruler. They will be your biggest roadblock to victory, but they may also prove to be powerful allies. Unit enchantments. There are many paths to victory.